Chaitanya Bhutale Srimati Bhaktivedanta Swaminiti Namine Namaste Sarasati Devi Kauravani Pracharine Nirvisesha Shunyavadi Paschacha Deshatarine Vanchakaupatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhayevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jaya Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadhi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So we're going through the sixth canto of Srimad Bhagavatam, and we're on chapter number this is chapter number 4, and we're hearing the Hamsaguya prayers which are offered by Prajapati Daksha. So, the Supreme Personality of Godhead was very pleased to hear Prajapati Daksha offer these prayers.
至尊人格首神对于 Prajapati Daksha 供奉的这个祷文感觉到非常的满意。
So we'll hear what Prajapati Daksha had to say.
所以我们来听一听到底 Prajapati Daksha 他说了一些什么。
So he says, just like the sense objects cannot understand how the senses can perceive them. In other words, the sense objects, like the sense of taste, cannot understand how it is that the tongue is able to perceive the taste.
这个滋味它并不知道舌头是如何能品尝到这个滋味的。
In the same way, the sense of smell cannot understand how it is the nose is able to perceive the smell.
同样的气味它也无法了解鼻子是如何感知到这个气味的存在的。
So in the same way, conditioned soul, although he lives in the body, along with the super soul, he cannot understand the supreme super soul, cannot understand how that super soul is there with him.
同样的，尽管受条件限制的灵魂和超灵在一起，都在躯体之中，但是他并不了解超灵是如何作为至尊者的。
He cannot understand how that super soul is using his senses.
他也无法理解这个超灵是如何在使用他的感官的。
So he offers his obeisances unto the Supreme Person.
因此他向这位至尊人物致以顶拜。
So the individual soul and the super soul live together in the same body.
个体灵魂和超灵居住在同一个躯体之中。
Just like two birds are in the one tree.
就像两只鸟住在同一棵树上。
One bird is eating the fruit of the tree, and the other bird is a witness.
其中一只鸟在啄食树上的果实，另外一只鸟在见证着这只鸟的活动。
So the bird eating the fruit is like the conditioned living being.
这个吃果子的这个鸟就像我们这些个体生物一样。
And then the individual living being is sitting with the super soul, but he cannot see the super soul sitting with him.
这个个体灵魂和超灵坐在一起，但是这个个体灵魂他却看不到超灵。
But actually, it's the super soul who is directing his senses to enjoy.
但是事实上是这个超灵在指导着个体灵魂去享受。
And for the senses, their enjoyment is the sense objects.
是超灵指导着他在享受这些感官对象。
But the sense objects cannot see the senses.
感官对象看不到感官。
Just like the conditioned soul cannot see the super soul.
同样的，这些个体灵魂也看不到指导着他的超灵。
But the conditioned soul has desires.
受条件限制的灵魂是有愿望的。
And the super soul arranges for the conditioned soul to satisfy these desires.
超灵安排个体灵魂去满足享受这些愿望。
But at the same time, he never sees the super soul.
但与此同时，个体灵魂从来没有看到过超灵。
So Prajapati Daksha offers his obeisances to the super soul. Although he's unable to see him.
所以 Prajapati Daksha 向这个超灵致以顶拜，虽然他看不见这位超灵。
Another example is how ordinary people work under the direction of the government.
另外一个例子就是普通的老百姓，他在政府的指导下在工作。
The ordinary people, they cannot understand what the government is.
普通老百姓他们通常无法了解政府是什么。
And they cannot understand how they're being governed, how they're being told what to do.
他也无法理解他们是如何被管理的。
Just like different servants in a big department of a big company, cannot see the supreme boss under whom everybody is working.
就像在一个庞大机构的很多这些工人和仆人，他们并不了解这个机构背后的大老板是哪一位。
The same way the conditioned souls cannot see the supreme lord who is their friend sitting within their body.
同样的，这些个体灵魂他也看不到跟他居住在同一个躯体中的这一位至尊者以超灵形式的这个超灵的在他身边。
Because that super soul is invisible to our material vision.
因为超灵对于我们这种物质的视域是隐形的。
In the same way, the sense objects, they cannot know, the sense objects don't know their own nature.
同样的，这些感官对象也无法了解它们自身的本性。
And they don't know the nature of the other senses.
他们也不知道其他感官的这个情况。
And they don't know the nature of their controller.
他们更不知道控制者的本性。
But the living being is by spirit, he's by nature, he's spiritual.
但是生物的本性是灵性的。
So he can know about his body and his life here and the senses.
他能够知晓自己的躯体，他的生命之气以及他的感官。
He can know also about the sense objects and the elements.
他也能够了解感官对象以及这些不同的元素。
And he knows also the qualities of the sense objects.
他也了解这些感官对象的品质。
So although he's aware, the living being, he knows about all these things, he's unable to see the Supreme Being.
尽管这个个体生物能够知晓所有的这些东西，但是他仍然不能了解至尊主。
And that Supreme Being knows everything and he's unlimited.
这位至尊的生物知道着一切，他也是无限的。
Just like material scientists study the different elements of the material world.
物质科学家对物质世界的各种元素进行研究。
But they cannot understand that above all these things, there's a spirit soul.
但是他们无法理解在所有的这些元素之上的这位至尊的灵魂。
So the living entity, because he's spiritual, he can understand all the material objects.
因为生物它是灵性的，所以它能够理解这些物质的对象。
And when he's self-realized, he can understand the Paramatma.
当生物能够获得自我觉悟的时候，它也能觉悟到超灵的存在。
But even if he's advanced,He still cannot understand the Supreme Personality of Godhead.
即便他很精进，这个生物很精进，他仍然无法了解至尊人格什么身份。
Because the Supreme Lord is so unlimited.
因为至尊主非常的无限。
So Prajapati Daksha prays that when our consciousness becomes purified of the contamination.Of material existence, then.
Prajapati Daksha 祈祷到，当我们人的知觉彻底从物质污染的这些存在中得到净化的时候。
And when the mind is in a deep sleep.
当我们的心意在深度的睡眠中时
when it's not in a deep sleep
不处在当我们的心意并没有处在深度的睡眠中时
then the living being comes to the platform of trance
这样这个个体生物能够处在超然的处在神定的层面。
Then the material vision and the memories of the mind are disappear.
那个时候，物质的视觉以及心意的记忆就会消失。
So when we get to that trance.Then we're able to see the personality of Godhead.
在那样的神定之中，我们才能够见得到至尊的人格受身。
So there are two stages to God realization.
所以有两个层面，获得就觉悟的两个层面。
So one is very easily understood.By mental speculation.
有一种是通过心意推敲，心智推敲是很容易理解的。
And the other is understood only with great difficulty.
另一种被称为难以理解的。
So Paramatma realization and Brahman realization, they're quite easy.
这个 超灵的觉悟或凡的觉悟是非常sorry, Guru Lee, is quite easy or not easy?
Yeah, quite easy.
是容易理解的。
But to realize the Supreme Personality of Godhead, that's the difficult one.
但是如果要理解至尊人格守神，却是很难以理解。
So we want to get full realization, we want to realize the Personality of Godhead, we have to give up the activities of the mind.
如果我们想要理解至尊人格守神的这种获得这种觉悟的话，我们得放弃心意的推敲。
Thinking, feeling, and willing.
思想、感受或者意愿，放弃这种活动。
It means we have to stop mental speculation.
我们得放弃这种心智的推敲。
So this realization, this is.Above the stage of deep sleep.
这种觉悟是在深度睡眠之上的觉悟。
In our conditioned state, we can see, we can understand things by our own experience and our own memories.
在通常的粗糙的物质条件情况下，我们可以通过我们的经验和记忆去感知这些事物。
And in the subtle stage, we can understand the world in dreams.
在精微的状态下，我们可以通过梦去感知这个世界。
So, other process is based on remembrance. It's also a subtle form.
那些以记忆方式存在的，就是包括记忆等等这些方式，也是一种精微的存在，精微的形式去感知这个世界。
So we have to get above the gross experience and the stage of dreaming.
因此我们应该超越这种粗糙的经验之上，超越这种梦的之上。
And when we come to the spiritual platform, then we transcend all these lower stages, and we come to we get to trance.
当我们到达灵性的这个层面的时候，我们会超越这种粗糙的以及轻微的这些低下的层面，会达到神定状态。
That's the level of pure goodness, and we can see the personality of Godhead.
这是处在超然的善良形态层面之上，那个时候我们可以看到至尊人格守神。
But so long as we're on the platform of duality of the senses.Thinking this is good and bad, then we will never understand Krishna.
只要我们还处在一种二元性、二重性，比如说这是好的，这是坏的，处在这样的一种层面上的时候，我们仍然不能理解 Krishna.
But when we use our senses in the service of Krishna, then we can engage the tongue to chant the holy name.And taste Krishna Prasada.
但是当我们用我们的感官从事对主的服务的时候，比如说用舌头去唱诵圣名的时候，我们可以品尝到 Krishna.
Yeah, then we can realize Krishna. This, all right. So by giving service to Krishna, we become purified.
通过给予 Krishna 奉献服务，我们能够得到净化。
So Daksha offers his obeisances unto the Supreme Lord, who is he knows the Supreme Lord is revealed by purity when we are pure.
Daksha 向至尊人格守神致以顶拜，他知道只有当我们净化纯净的时候，至尊人格守神才能揭示他自己。
We want to know the Lord, we have to be pure. We have to purify ourselves first, then we can understand the Lord.
我们想要了解至尊主，那么我们就得净化我们自己。当我们净化之后，我们才能够理解至尊主。
And we can know how great the Lord is.
我们才能够理解至尊主他是多么的伟大。
So Daksha says, he talks about.How the Brahmanas are very expert in performing ritualistic ceremonies and sacrifices.
Daksha 继续说到这个，他说 Brahma 是非常善于做伟大仪式以及祭祀这些活动的。
And these Brahmanas know how to chant mantras which will bring fire out of the wood.
Brahmana 也非常了解如何通过唱诵曼陀罗从木里面取得火。
So that proves the power of their mantras.
这也证明了曼陀罗的力量。
So the same way, those people who are actually advanced in spiritual life, who are actually Krishna conscious, they can find the super soul.
同样的，那些在灵性方面有着进步的人，那些有着 Krishna 知觉的人，他们能够在内心之中觉悟到超灵。
They know the Lord is situated within the heart, but he's covered by the three modes of material nature.
他们知道至尊主在他们内心居住着，但是呢，被物质自然三属性所覆盖着。
And he's also covered by the nine material elements.
他还被九种物质元素所覆盖着。
And the five objects of sense gratification are also covering him.
以及五种物质元素，五个也覆盖着他。
And the five material elements and the ten senses.
五种物质元素和十个感官覆盖着它。
So the external energy is made up of 27 elements.
主的外在能量由这种27种元素构成。
And the great yogis, they meditate upon the Lord, who is the super soul within the heart of all living entities.
伟大的瑜伽师冥想以超灵的形式居住于内心的主。
So Prajapati Daksha prays that the super soul will be pleased with him.
Prajapati Daksha 祈祷愿至尊主能够对他愿主能够对他满意。
When we are eager to get liberation from the material world, then we will be able to realize the super soul.
当我们非常渴望想从物质生命状态之中得到解脱的时候，我们才能够觉悟到超灵。
And when we get that liberation, then we can engage in devotional service to the Lord.
当我们得到那种解脱的时候，我们可以从事对至尊主的奉献服务。
So the Lord can be addressed by many spiritual names.
主可以被冠以各种灵性的名字。
These names may be inconceivable to our material senses.
但是这些名字对于我们物质的感官来说是非常不可思议的。
So Daksha prays, when will the Supreme Lord be pleased with me?
Daksha 说，什么时候至尊人格守神会对我满意呢？
So that pure stage of existence is.Quite difficult to realize, to come to that stage of pure.
到达那种纯洁的层面是非常难以到达的。
In the Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna describes it. He says that people should act piously in previous lives and in this life.
主 Krishna 在《薄伽梵歌》中说。在今生前世，这个人得活动虔诚。
And their sinful activity should be all destroyed.
他的所有的罪恶活动都应该被摧毁。
And they should be free from the duality of delusion.
而且他不应该再受二重性的迷惑。
But then they can engage in service to Krishna with determination.
这样他才能够坚定不移地从事对我的奉爱服务。
And then also in the ninth chapter, Krishna also says, a Mahatma, a great devotee, is always chanting the glories of Krishna.
主 Krishna 在薄伽梵歌第九章也描述到，这位 Mahatma 就是伟大的灵魂，他是如何总是恒常地唱颂我的荣耀。
And he's making great efforts with great determination.
他做出巨大的努力以及巨大的决心。
He bows down before Krishna.
他向 Krishna 顶拜。
And he worships Krishna with devotion.
他以爱心崇拜着 Krishna.
So once we get over, once we're able to transcend the material impediments, then we can understand Krishna.
当人超越了所有的物质障碍之后。才能够理解 Krishna.
So Krishna himself says in Bhagavad Gita, this is not very common, it's quite rare that someone can do that.
主 Krishna 在薄伽梵歌也提到，这样的一种事情是非常罕见的，并不是很常见发生的，能达到这种层面是非常罕有的。
Only one in thousands is even trying for perfection, and of those who have achieved perfection,Hardly one knows Krishna in truth.
千千万万人之中，只有一个人或许想要去，或许有一个人努力达到完美。而在那些达到完美的人之中，几乎没有一个人能够真正的了解我。
So we want to understand Krishna, we have to be willing to do a lot of penance and austerity.
如果我们想要了解 Krishna, 我们得从事很多的苦行。
And we do that by practicing devotional service.
但是我们是通过做奉爱服务能达到这一切。
We can understand Krishna simply by devotion.
我们只有通过奉献服务，我们才能够理解 Krishna.
And when we have full consciousness of Krishna, then we can go to the Krishna's kingdom.
当我们有全然的 Krishna 的知觉，这样我们才能够回到 Krishna 的王国之中。
So although it's difficult to understand Krishna, it's easy if you follow the proper method.
虽然了解 Krishna, 理解 Krishna 很难，但是如果我们遵循这个道路的话，是很简单的。
And we can come in touch with Krishna by doing devotional service.
而且我们可以通过做奉献服务来触碰到 Krishna.
And devotional service begins with hearing and chanting.
奉献服务是以聆听和唱诵为开始。
When we start hearing and chanting, then the sound vibrations enter the heart, and in this way we become pure devotees.
当我们开始聆听和唱诵的时候，超然的音阵进入到我们的内心，我们会变成纯粹的奉献者。
And we have to keep hearing and chanting, and we will develop transcendental love.
我们继续的聆听和唱诵的话，我们会发展出超然的爱。
And then we will come to know Krishna's name and form and qualities and pastimes.
这样之后，我们可以了解到。智者仁波切 Krishna 的名字、形体、品质和逍遥时光。
So although there's many obstacles to see Krishna, if somebody does devotional service, they can see Krishna easily.
虽然了解看到 Krishna 会有很多的障碍，如果一个人能够做奉献服务，他能够很轻易的看到 Krishna.
All of these obstacles are just different energies of Krishna.
所有这些障碍只是 Krishna 不同的能量而已。
So a devotee, he it just comes in contact with Krishna. It just directly comes in contact with Krishna.
奉献者直接能够与 Krishna 接触。
He doesn't worry about the obstacles because he knows they're just Krishna's energy.
他并不担心这些物质的障碍，他知道这些障碍只是 Krishna 的能量而已。
So when someone's eager to see Krishna, then we can pray to Krishna just like Lord Chaitanya prays in the Shikshastika.
当奉献者很渴望去见到 Krishna 的时候。 他可以向主 Krishna 祈祷，就像主 Chaitanya 在八训归中所说的。
Right, then in the fifth verse, Lord Chaitanya said, "I am your eternal servant. Somehow or other, I've fallen into the ocean of birth and death. Please pick me up and fix me as one of the atoms at your feet."
我是你永恒的仆人，但不知怎的，我跌落了生死苦海，请从生死苦海中提起我，并且将我如一个原子放在您的莲花足上。So
all the material obstacles, they just become devote, they become spiritual, they become part of our service to Krishna.
因此，所有的物质障碍都转变成灵性服务的一部分。Just
in the material world. The energy of Krishna is it is coming to give us misery.
在物质世界之中，主 Krishna 的灵性能量展示为引起我们的痛苦。
So everybody wants to get happiness, and that happiness comes from Krishna's pleasure potency.
每一个人都在追求快乐，而这种快乐。 来自于至尊人格守神的，来自于 Krishna 的喜乐能量。But
in the material world, that pleasure potency becomes gives us misery.
但是在物质世界之中，这种快乐能量却变成了我们痛苦的源。
What we thought was going to give us happiness in the material world just gives us a lot of distress.
那些我们认为能够给我们带来快乐的，却给我们带来了痛苦。And
when we try for happiness, then we think about going towards Krishna to satisfy Krishna.
当我们追求快乐的努力转向去满足 Krishna 的时候
，then that misery. All changes and it becomes happiness.
那个时候的所有的痛苦都会转变成快乐。Just
like when you have wood and you want to take fire from wood, then it's difficult.
就像我们手上有一个木头，我们想要在木中来取火是非常困难的。But
once the fire comes out of the wood. Then the wood easily burns to ashes.
但是当火一旦点燃，这个木头就马上成为灰烬。So
in the same way, it's difficult to experience Krishna.
同样的，对于我们来说，要体验、要觉悟到 Krishna， 经验到 Krishna 是很困难。If
we don't do devotional service, then very difficult to experience Krishna.
如果我们并不从事奉献服务的话，要觉悟到 Krishna， 要体验 Krishna， 非常困难。
But once we start doing devotional service, then it becomes so easy for a devotee to meet Krishna.
但是，一旦人开始从事对 Krishna 奉献服务的时候，要体验到 Krishna 是非常容易的。
Krishna's form is not material; it's inconceivable.
Krishna 的形象不是物质的，它是不可思议的。
So as devotees, we should pray to Krishna. We should pray to Krishna. Please be pleased with me, so that I can see your form.
奉献者会向主祈祷道：“我的主啊，请对我满意。这样的话，我才能够看到你的形体。”
Non people who are not devotees. They just talk about the Brahman. They just talk about, oh, it's not this, not this. They just talk only about negation.
那些非奉献者总是在只是在讨论 Brahman， 说，不是这个，不是那个。
But devotees, simply by chanting the holy name, they're able to realize the existence of the Lord very easily.
但是奉献者只是唱诵主的圣名，他就能够理解到至尊主的存在，很轻易地觉察到主的存在。
They don't worry about mental speculation.
他们不进行心智思推敲。
So Prajapati Daksha goes on to talk about, he says, he's talking about the effects of the modes of nature.
Prajapati Daksha 现在就开始讲物质自然属性、物质自然本性它的影响。
So anything that he says anything experienced by the material senses or which comes in your mind,It's just the effect of the modes of nature.
他说一切物质感知所感觉到的，在心意中所感觉到的一切，都只是物质自然属性影响的这些结果。
It has nothing to do with the real nature of the Supreme Lord.
它与至尊人格守神的真正本性毫无关系。
The Supreme Lord is far beyond the creation of the material world.
至尊主远超越于这个物质世界的创造。
He and from him all the material qualities and creation come about.
从至尊主那儿，所有的物质自然、物质的品质和创造，它是根源。
The Supreme Lord, He is the cause of the creation. He was here before the creation, and He is here after the creation.
至尊主是万源之源，他是创造之前，也是创造之后。
So if somebody makes up forms and qualities for the Supreme Lord, then they cannot understand him.
如果有人他捏造至尊人格守神的名字形体，他无法了解至尊主。
Because the Lord is far beyond our material mind and senses.
因为至尊主远远超越于我们的物质的心意和感官。
Yeah, He is the creator of everything.
他是一切的创造者。
And he is the cause of all causes.
他是万源之源，原因的原因。
So his name and form and qualities are not material.
他的名字、形体和品质都不是物质的。
Everything about him is transcendental.
他的一切都是超然的。
So we cannot understand the Supreme Lord by our limited mind and senses.
我们不可能通过我们有限的心意和感官去理解至尊主。
So Daksha offers his prayers unto the transcendence. He's not offering the prayers unto anybody and unto any person. He's just offering prayers unto the transcendence.
Prajapati Daksha, 他是向超然者，这位超然者在供奉祷文，他不是向任某个个人、某个物质创造中的个人供奉，他是向超然者在供奉祷文。
Yeah, he's not offering to anyone within the material creation.
他并不是向物质创造里面的某个人去供奉祷文。
You have to be stupid to think God is a material person.
只有愚蠢的人才认为神只是物质创造中的一个。
And Krishna himself says the same in the Bhagavad Gita.
Krishna 本人在《薄伽梵歌》中说了这一点。
The foolish people think I'm an ordinary person.
愚蠢的人认为我是一个普通的人。
So we have to get this knowledge from a person who knows the Lord.
我们得从一位了解主的那里人 了解主的这个人的内里去获得知识。
We cannot just make up a name or a form for the Lord herself.
我们不能通过我们自己去给主编造一个名字或者形体。
So we have to hear from somebody who's actually knowing the Lord.
我们得从一位他知道主的这个人那里去了解。
So Shankaracharya, he was an impersonalist, but he would say, Narayana Parovyaktat, that Lord Narayana is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, and he's not of the material world.
Shankaracharya 是一位非人格主义者，但他却说到 Narayana, 至尊人格首身 Narayana, 不是物质世界之中的那个，不是一位物质世界之中的人。
So we cannot make Lord Narayana some material on some material position.
我们也不能给 Narayana 一个物质的称谓或者地位。
Some stupid people, they talk about Lord Narayana being a poor person. That's a great an offense.
有一些愚蠢的人说这个 Narayana 是一个贫穷的人，这是一个冒犯。
Lord Narayana is always transcendental, beyond the material creation.
主 Narayana 永远是超然的，而且超越于物质创造。
So somebody may be poor in the material world, but in the spiritual world, there's no poverty.
有一些人或许在物质世界是很贫穷的，但是在灵性世界不存在着贫穷这一回事。
So we cannot think Lord Narayana is poor. That's totally wrong.
因此，我们不能说 Narayana 是一个贫穷的，这是完全错误的。
In the same way, material names cannot be names for the Supreme Lord also.
同样的，物质的称谓也不能用来称呼主。
So we cannot understand the Supreme Lord simply by our own, by taking names from a dictionary or taking words from a dictionary.
因此，我们也不能从我们字典中去挑一个词，去从那里去了解至尊人格首身。
So Daksha is praying to the Lord.But he does not want material names to be given to the Lord.
Daksha 在向主祈祷，但是他不希望用物质世界的物质的名字去灌，就是给予主。
He wants to worship the Lord who existed before the creation.
他希望崇拜在这个物质存在、物质创造之前就存在的那位主。
So everything about the Lord, there's nothing about the Lord which one can understand by our material senses.
Sorry, Gurudev, some break.
We cannot understand Krishna just by looking through a dictionary, taking words from the dictionary.
我们不可能只是从字典中的一些词去了解 Krishna.
But if we understand Krishna by devotional service, then we can understand properly.
如果我们通过奉献服务去了解至尊主的话，了解 Krishna 的话，那个才是恰当。
We have to be on the transcendental platform to understand Krishna.
我们得到达超然的层面去了解至尊主。
Then by the grace of Krishna himself, then we can understand Krishna.
而且通过主的仁慈 ，Krishna 本人的仁慈，我们也可以了解 Krishna。
So simply by understanding Krishna.Then we become qualified to go back to Godhead.
仅仅只需要了解 Krishna， 我们都有资格回归受身。
Anybody who desires to get free from the material world of birth and death, we have to hear and chant and also remember the Supreme Lord.
任何想要超越生老病死、想要回归的人，他都应该聆听、唱诵以及记忆至尊主。
He is the super soul and the controller and the savior from all miseries.
他是超灵控制者，而且使人摆脱所有的痛苦的拯救者。
So the Supreme Brahman is the ultimate resting place and source of everything.
至尊 Brahman 是终极的栖息所和万事万物的根源。
Everything belongs to him.
一切都属于他。
Everything should be offered to him.
一切都得供奉给他。
So it doesn't matter if he's acting or doing things to others. He is the ultimate cause.
无论是活动还是引起他人活动，他都是终极的活动者，终极的原因。
There are many causes, high and low, but he is the cause of all causes.
有很多原因，有高等的、低等的原因，但是他是所有原因的原因。
So he is the Supreme Brahman who existed before all activities.
他是至尊的 Brahman。
And he is one without a second.
他也是独一无二的。
He has no other cause.
除了他之外没有其他的原因。
So in the Bhagavad Gita also says the same thing, that everything comes from him, everything material and spiritual, it all comes from him.
主 Krishna 在《薄伽梵歌》中也确认一切灵性的和物质的都是来源于他。
Right, the material world is under the control of the material nature, but that also comes from Krishna.
物质世界虽然在物质自然的控制之下，但是这一切都还是来自于 Krishna.
If the material world was not a part of the body of the Supreme Lord, then the Lord would not be complete.
如果物质世界不是他躯体的一部分，那么至尊主他就不是完整的。
We have to understand everything comes from Krishna. It means everything material and spiritual.
我们得理解到一切都是来源于他的，无论是灵性的还是物质的。
So if we know that Krishna Vasudeva is the cause of all causes, then we are perfect devotee.
如果我们能理解到 Vasudeva 他是一切原因的根源，那么他将会是一位完美的奉献者。
And Lord Brahma says the same thing in his prayers in the very first verse.
主 Brahma 在他的祈祷文里面以第一个世界也说了同样的事情。
Krishna is the cause of all causes.
Krishna 是万源之源。
And there is no cause for his appearance.
对于他来说，他没有其他的根源。
And Krishna expands in many, many forms.
Krishna 扩展出许多许多的形体。
But ultimately, they're all one.
但是终极来讲，他们都是一，都是一个。
He's one.Because all of his forms, Swamsa, all the different forms of Krishna, the Swamsa, Navibhinamsa, are not different from him. So Daksha says, let me offer my obeisances unto this Supreme Person who possesses unlimited transcendental qualities.
达克小说，让我向这位至尊人格守神致以前进的顶拜，他拥有无限的超然品质。
And because he's in the heart of everyone, he's in the heart of all these philosophers who present all their different theories.
而且他由于他处在每一个生物体的心中，他也处在这些所有的哲学家的心中，让他们创造出不同的哲学的观点。
And it causes them to forget about their own soul.
这就让他们忘记他们自身的灵魂。
And sometimes they agree, and sometimes they disagree with each other.
有些时候他们赞同对方，有些时候他们反对对方。
So they can never come to any conclusion about who's right.
因此他们也得不出最终的谁是正确的。
So since the beginning of creation, people have been arguing with each other about the cause of the creation.
自创造以来，不同的人总是为这个创造有不同的论点。
Non-devotees, they have different ideas about the creation and maintenance and destruction.
这些非奉献者对于创造有不同的观点。
So, in the Mahabharata, it says like that, that there are many different speculators, all with different theories.
在 Mahabharata 中也有说到，有很多种不同类型的心智思辨者。
And they're always arguing with each other.
他们总是相互辩论。
So philosophy is about finding the ultimate cause.
哲学的意思是为了寻找到终极的原因。
Just like in the Vedanta Sutra, it says in the beginning, human life is meant to understand what is Brahman.
就像在 Vedanta Sutra 的开始中说到，人类是为了了解到Brahman.
Right, and the devotees, we accept that Krishna is the supreme Brahman.
而奉献者接受 Krishna 作为至尊的 Brahma.
And this is supported with the scriptures and by Krishna himself.
而这个也被 Krishna 本人所证实。
So devotee has no problem to understand the cause of everything, Krishna.
奉献者对于理解一切的根源没有问题，他理解到一切都是 Krishna.
But not people who are not devotees.They cannot understand.
但是那些非奉献者，他们无法理解。
Everyone wants to, they all want to have their own philosophy. Their philosophy should be the best.
每一个人都想有他们一套自己的哲学，而且认为自己的那套哲学就是最好的。
And each one will present their philosophy and oppose all the other people.
每一个有这些哲学有自成一系的这些哲学，然后又派生出其他的这些人。
And this is true in India. It's also true in the West.
这个在印度发生着，也在西方国这些国家也发生着这样的事情。
In Western countries, that philosophers have different ideas about creation.
西方的这些哲学家们对于创造也有不同的观点。
So there's so many different philosophies, and each of them are contradicting the other one.
在这个世界上有太多的哲学家，每一个哲学家都跟另外一个哲学家，他们之间是矛盾的。
So we will wonder why are there so many different philosophies?
所以我们会有疑问，到底为什么会有这么多的哲学呢？
The ultimate goal, the ultimate cause is one, the Supreme Brahman. Why are there so many different philosophies?
既然终极的原因只有一个是至尊的 Brahman 的话，为什么有这么多的哲学家呢？
In the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna declares Arjuna as the Supreme Brahman.
在博迦梵歌中，阿尔朱纳告诉 Krishna,说您就是至尊 Brahman.
But the non-devotees, those speculators, non-devotees, they cannot accept this. They won't accept Krishna.
但是那些非奉献者，他们并不接受 Krishna 为至尊的 Brahma。
They cannot even understand the soul and its activities。
他们甚至都无法理解出这个灵魂的活动。
They may have a little idea about the soul, but they have so many other ideas about the conclusion. They can never get the real conclusion.
他们或许对灵魂有那么一丁点的概念，但是不知道这个结论是怎样。
They're all envious of Krishna.
他们都对 Krishna 还很嫉妒。
And because they're all envious of Krishna, Krishna puts them into the ocean of material existence.
因为他们嫉妒 Krishna, 所以 Krishna 会把他们放到这种物质存在的海洋之中。
And they take birth in different demoniac species of life, birth after birth.
而且在邪恶的生命种族之中不停地轮回。
Because of their offenses,Krishna keeps them always bewildered.
因为他们是冒犯者，所以 Krishna 总是让他们处于困惑之中。
Keeps them in darkness.
让他们处于黑暗之中。
So these people who are demons who are against Krishna, they cannot understand his transcendental qualities.
这些恶魔反对 Krishna 的恶魔，他们无法了解 Krishna 的超然品质。
They're all envious of Krishna and Krishna's qualities.
他们都嫉妒 Krishna 以及 Krishna 的品质。
And they say this whole world that there's no controller and everything just goes by chance.
他们认为这个世界没有控制者，一切都只是。
So they can never understand the real cause of all causes.
因此他们永远无法理解万缘之源。
So this is why there are so many different philosophies in the material world.
这就是为什么在物质世界有这么多的哲学家的原因。
Okay. So we will stop here.I will ask if there's any questions.
Not yet.
Okay, so we're hearing these nice prayers by Prajapati Daksha.
We're now listening to Prajapati Daksha's 这个祷文。
Praying is one of the nine angas of devotional service.
呈现着九个奉献服务。
And we also have to learn to pray.
我们也祈祷是九项奉献服务中的一种，我们也得学会如何去祈祷。
We all have to.Offer our prayers to Krishna, to be able to speak to Krishna and know how to address him.
我们也得了解如何向 Krishna, 如何跟 Krishna 说话，如何去描述 Krishna.
So it's customary when you offer prayers to the Lord that you should first of all glorify him.
通常情况下我们如果要跟主 Krishna 向他祈祷的话，我们先要荣耀主 Krishna。
And then after glorifying him, then if you have some request, you may want to request some particular something from him, then you can tell him。
在我们荣耀完主 Krishna 之后，我们或许会有一些请求，在荣耀完他之后，我们可以把我们的请求告诉给他。
So this is the standard procedure in offering prayers to the Lord.
这个是我们向主供奉祷文的这个程序。Hare Krishna, 这个 Yogita Sharma 有一个问题好像。
Okay.
Okay. Yogita Sharma,
yes,
you can speak.
You.
Okay.
Hare Krishna Gurudev, please accept my humble obeisances.
Yes, Hare Krishna,
Gurudev,
my obeisances.
Hare Gurudev, as you said earlier, that only after liberation, actually, one can perform devotional service to the Lord. So should we take, then when we're doing sadhana bhakti, which is only in the practice stage, the first stage of practice, should we look at it this way? Like you said in the class that you gave in Russia, that the Lord allows us to taste a tinge of happiness, a little bit of happiness from the nectar of ocean in the spiritual world. So is it also that maybe he allows us to taste the actual devotional service that is being performed in the spiritual world by allowing us to taste a bit over here? Can we look at it this way while doing sadhana bhakti, or how is it going?
Yes, well,
Hare Krishna, 让我先翻译一下故事的。他的这个问题是，因为在今天的讲课中提到，只有当我们处于解脱的时候，我们才能够做奉献服务，能达到这个在解脱的层面下才能做奉献服务这个层面。马古尔在之前的这个讲，在对俄罗斯人讲课中也说到一个，我们所品尝到的快乐是 Krishna 原本的快乐，它只是给我们的一个品尝。所以呢，这个 Madhaji 的问题是能不能这样理解？我们现在所做的 sadhana bhakti 就是这种练习中的奉爱服务，只是 Krishna 给我们的这个奉爱服务的一种品尝而已。Hare Krishna.
Well, we understand from the Bhagavad Gita, 18th chapter, that devotional service begins on the platform of Brahmabhuta.
在薄伽梵歌中，我们了解到奉爱服务起始于 Brahmabhuta 的这个阶段。
Brahmabhuta means the liberate platform of that one is liberated.
Brahmabhuta 意味着一个人他是处于解脱的层面。
We've understood you're not the body.
这意味着你理解到，你觉悟到我们不是这个躯体。
Of course, we have to go on from there to understand more about our real self.
当然我们应该超越这个，我们应该了解更多，我们不仅仅只是要了解这么一点点，我们了解关于我们自我的更多。
And understand our relationship with the Supreme Lord.
我们还得了解我们和至尊主的关系。
So, you were saying devotional service and practice. Devotional service and practice actually...really begins at the stage of Nishta, after we've gone through Anartha Nivritti.
奉献服务 Sadhana Bhakti 的这个奉献服务起始于 Nishta, 就是说我们有坚定的这个信心。
It's not that just anybody is, you know, that we're, because we're chanting Hare Krishna and everything, so we're doing devotional service, so we're transcendental. We have to get rid of the anattas, the contamination in the heart.
不是说那个我们随随便便唱诵 Hare Krishna, 做一做这样就我们就处于一个超然层面，我们就是一个奉献者。我们必须得放弃我们内心的这些 anatta, 这些不洁。
We have to understand what is pure devotional service.
我们也得理解到到底什么是纯粹的奉献服务。
What is the liberated platform?
到底什么是解脱的层面呢？
Liberated platform means we're above the modes of nature. We've got free of the modes of nature.
解脱的层面是我们处在物质自然属性之上。我们超越这个物质自然属性。
So, we want to work with this understanding.
我们是以这种理解去工作的。
Yes, sometimes Krishna does give us a little taste. of what is transcendental pleasure.
是的 ，Krishna 有时候给我们一点点的品味，到底什么是超然的快乐。
But he wants us to come to the actual platform of pure devotion.
但是他也希望我们能够来到这种纯粹奉爱服务的层面之上。
You want to become dear to Krishna? We have to be pure.
你想与 Krishna 变得很亲近的话，你得变得很纯洁。
Of course, we have to be humble. We have to remember that we're unqualified.
当然，我们也得时常的记着，我们并没有资格。
But Krishna reciprocates. The more we desire, the more Krishna will help us.
但是 Krishna 会帮助我们。我们越多的渴望的话 ，Krishna 会越多的帮助。
You take one step towards Krishna, Krishna will take 10 steps towards you.
我们向 Krishna 迈一步 ，Krishna 会向我们迈十步。
Understand?
您理解吗
？Yogita, you understand?
When we are in the temple serving the deities, because Sri Sri Gaurinitha are actually standing there, so we're actually touching their lotus feet and actually serving them, right? I mean, how do I? Of course, a lot of purification is definitely anytime needed, but when we're doing seva in the temple, you know, to their lordships,What about that stage, Gurudev? We are actually touching their lotus feet, aren't we?
Mataji 又问，当我们在这个庙里面实际的去给神像做服务的这个时候，是一种什么样的层面呢？我们到底是不是真正的触碰了至尊人格守神本人他的莲花足呢
？Well.You want to be a little cautious. You don't want to just go and disturb the Lord by touching his lotus feet. It's not very proper.
我们得有一点在意，就是说我们不要去打扰到，我们不要去触碰至尊主的莲花足去打扰他。
We want to serve Krishna's lotus feet.
我们是想要去服务至尊主的莲花座。
You're not just in the temple just to only touch his feet and to take mercy and ask for cheap blessings.
我们不是在庙里面很廉价的触碰至尊主的莲花座，然后去想得到一个很廉价的祝福。我们想的是要去服务主的莲花座。
We have to develop our Krishna consciousness and we want to come more into our relationship with Krishna.
我们想要是和 Krishna 有更多的这种关系。
Developing our love for Krishna. Remember, love.
发展出对 Krishna 的爱。
Love means to give service unconditionally.
爱意味着无条件的这种服务，不受条件限制的这种服务。
Sorry, Gurudev, I should have corrected my words. Yes, by serving their lordships in the temple, definitely, it's definitely service. Not only touching their lordship, but actually serving them completely.Understood, Gurudev, very much. Thank you very much, Gurudev.
And we should remember always that we are practicing devotional service. So practice means we follow the rules and regulations. You should know the different details, what we should do and what we shouldn't do.
我们也得了解，我们是处在练习中的奉献服务。练习中的奉献服务意味着我们时刻的铭记我们的这些规范原则是什么，到底我们该做什么，我们不该做什么。
Yeah. So the more serious we are, the more careful we will be to follow all the rules and regulations.
我们越是严肃的话，我们越更多的去追随这些规范和规范原则。
And the most important of our regulative principles is to always remember Krishna and never forget him.
而所有的这些原则之中的核心就是永远记住 Krishna， 永远不忘记 Krishna。
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.Are there any other question?
Yes. Next question from Huawei. 奉爱瑜伽如何解释潜意识？ Let me. How did the Bhakti Yoga explain the deep?Consciousness. Subconscious.
Oh, subconscious.
Yes, yes. Yes. How did Bhakti Yoga explain this?
Well, we have different levels of consciousness. There's the bodily consciousness. There's consciousness of the mind.And there's consciousness of the soul.
我们有很多不同层面的意识，比如说躯体的意识、心意的意识以及灵魂的意识。
And when the activities of the mind stop, then one can go deeper into his own consciousness.
当心意的这个意识停止的话，我们可以再往，我们便可以走到灵魂的意识。
So subconsciousness is understood to be the different thoughts which are there in our mind from past lives.
而潜意识实际上是一种心意的意识，它是来自于过去的，植根于我们内心的这些意识。
We don't remember our past lives.
We don't remember yet.
Yes.
我们并不记得我们的过去。
But we know we've had previous lives, many previous lives.
但是我们知道我们过去有很多的生世。
And these have left impressions in our consciousness.
这些生世在我们的意识之中留下了一些印记和印象。
And that will provide, that's what our subconsciousness is.
这些就是我们的潜意识。
So we want to transcend all of these things and come to our pure consciousness.
我们想超越所有这些意识，来到纯粹的这种意识。
We want to come to...the level of knowing ourselves as the soul and the eternal servant of Krishna.
我们得到达这样的一种层面，我们了解到我们自己是灵魂，而且是 Krishna 永恒的仆人。
And ultimately, our subconsciousness, that will be there.
很自然的，这个潜意识还是会在那边。
In our subconsciousness, we're all servants of Krishna.
我们的潜意识、哦、我们的潜意识在那个时候还会在那里，但是我们的潜意识变成我们是 Krishna 的永恒的仆人。
Because we've all come to this material world, we've all come from the spiritual world to be here.
因为我们是来到这个物质世界的，我们是从灵性世界来到这个物质世界的。
But we have to remove all the other desires which are there in our subconsciousness.
但是我们要去除我们潜意识之中的其他的这些愿望。
So there's many coverings, there's many different layers of consciousness from many, many lifetimes.
由于我们很多的这些身世对我们的这些意识有很多的覆盖。
And at the bottom, at the deepest consciousness is that we're servant of Krishna.
而最深层次的那一种那一层意识是我们是 Krishna 永恒的仆人。
So that is our subconscious.
那是我们真正的潜意识。
But it's a big job to remove all these other layers of consciousness to come to that.
但是要去除掉所有的这些意识是一个很巨大的工作。
But just by chanting the holy name, we can clean all the heart.
只是通过唱诵圣名我们可以去洁净我们的内心。
The chanting of the holy name is the best way to think of Krishna.
唱诵圣名是我们让我们想起 Krishna 的最好的方式。
And when we're thinking of Krishna, then our heart is really getting clean.
当我们想起 Krishna 的时候，我们的内心才会得到真正的净化。
Okay.
Okay. Next question from S.E. 顶拜姑以及所有奉献者莲花组 ，Mahabharata 十万诗节是指第一篇吗？还是十八篇？现在上演的电视连续剧是第一部吗？感恩咕噜，十万。Obeisances to Guru, the Mahabharata have the 100,000 verses. It means the first canto or the 18th canto.
100,000 verse, 十万。
十万。
嗯。That's the whole.
是指的。Is the whole Mahabharata? Yes. 是指的十八篇。
But a lot of the Mahabharata is Bhishma giving instruction to Maharaj Yudhisthira.
但是更多的 Mahabharata 是指的 Bhishma 给 Yudhishthira Maharaj 的指导。
The battle is not so much. The battle of Kurukshetra, that's not so big story. But the bulk of the Mahabharata is Maharaj Yudhishthira taking instruction from Bhishma.
其实 Kuru 之野是那个战争并没有多少，而 Mahabharata 的这个大部分其实是在这个 Bhishma 给这个 Yudhishthira 的训示的这一部分。
Okay. What else did
the? He asked the TV series of Mahabharata is the first.Canto of the Mahabharata?
I don't know, I never saw it.
Okay. Next question from Vaishnavi Vani. My humble basis, my understanding is Prajapati Daksha is not a pure devotee, but his prayer are there in the Srimad Bhagavatam. Is these prayers are also important? Thank you. Vaishnava Vani Mataji 的这个问题是顶拜，请接受我卑微的顶拜。我的理解是 Prajapati Daksha 不是一个纯粹的奉献者，但是他的祈祷文在圣典波迦瓦坛中是的。这些祈祷文是同样的重要吗？谢谢。
Well, these prayers, first of all, they're not composed by Prajapati Daksha. They were there for a long time before Prajapati Daksha.
事实上, Prajapati Daksha的这个祷文 并不是由 Prajapati Daksha本人所写的, 他所撰写的这些祷文 远, 在 Prajapati Daksha出来之前 都已经存在了。
And he's pretty powerful devotee. He's a Prajapati. To be a Prajapati, you have to be a very, very advanced personality. You have to have a lot of pious activity.
他是一个很有力量的奉献者, 要成为一个 Prajapati 这个祖先, 他得做很多的虔诚活动才行。
Yeah, in his previous life, he made some offense.
是的, 在他的先前的时代, 他做了一些冒犯。
But he atoned for that, and he came back again, and he again got the position as Prajapati.
他为他的前世做了一些冒犯, 然后这一次再来了。 然后他得到了同样的这个地位 Prajapati.
So he's very powerful man. He has a lot of punya. And remember, when he offers the prayers, the Supreme Lord comes to him.
因此他是一个很有力量的人，我们也得再次的注意，当他供奉这个祷文的时候，至尊仁格首神本人来到了他的面前。
So certainly we should offer our respects to him.
所以当然我们也得对他尊敬。
He's very, very, very much more elevated than we are.
他肯定比我们更精进。
Yeah.
Okay. This question from SE, 哲学思辨。 和心智推敲是同一个概念吗? The philosophy speculation and the mental speculation are the same conception?
Yes, philosophical speculation and mental speculation, same.
是的,是同一个概念。 Next question from Hari Priya, Devi Nasi. 顶拜侮辱奉献者们, Daksha 觉悟了自我吗? 为什么会冒犯主 Shiva? Obeisance to Guru and devotees, the Daksha, does he realize himself why he offends the Lord Shiva?
Well, that was in the previous life he offended Lord Shiva.
那是在他之前的这一世,他冒犯了主 Shiva。
Yeah, he became offensive to Lord Shiva. He became proud. He was a Prajapati and he was doing great sacrifices, and many demigods were all coming to take part in the sacrifices.
他成了这个Prajapati，然后呢，邀请了很多的半神人来参加他的这个祭祀仪式的活动，他变得骄傲起来。
So, he, and you know, Lord, he had many daughters, and Sati was his daughter, his youngest daughter, and she was married to Lord Shiva. And Lord Shiva, well, Lord Shiva became like Daksha's son-in-law. So Daksha thought Lord Shiva should offer respects to him because he's his son-in-law.
Prajapati Daksha, 他有很多的女儿，其中一个女儿叫Sati，她嫁给了主Shiva。 于是主希瓦成为了他的女婿，他认为主希瓦应该向他致以尊敬或者说敬意，他认为希瓦是他的女婿。But
Lord Shiva is always meditating on the Supreme Lord, so Lord Shiva didn't offer respects to Daksha.
因为主希瓦总是在冥想着至尊主本人，所以他并没有向大Prajapati Daksha 致以。
So Daksha became angry at Lord Shiva for not respecting him.
Daksha 变得很生气，他认为主希瓦并不尊敬他。
So Sati, Lord Shiva decided, or Daksha decided he would not make any more offerings to Lord Shiva when they do the yagya.
Sorry, Gurudev.
Lord Daksha decided that when they do the yagya, they will not make any offerings to Lord Shiva.
Daksha 于是在做 yagya 的时候，不准备向主希望供奉任何的东西。
So Lord Shiva said, I'm not going to come for any more yagya.
所以希瓦说，我再也不来参加这些 yagya.
But Sati, she wanted to come.
但是 Sati, 她想来参加这个 yagya.
And when Sati came, then Daksha just ignored her. He didn't even speak to her.
当 Sati 来的时候， Daksha 对她忽视，甚至没有跟她说话。
So Sati felt very sorry that her father was such a demon.
所以 Sati 感觉到非常的悲伤，他认为他的这个父亲竟然是这样一个人。
That he was so offensive to Lord Shiva, that she decided.
他对主 Shiva 做出了这样的一种冒犯。
So Sati decided she didn't want to have any more relationship with him. She didn't want him to be her father.
Sati 这个时候甚至都不想让 Daksha 做他的父亲了，他甚至想跟他父亲就是断绝这种关系。
So she sat in meditation and she brought fire out from her body, burnt her body to ashes.
她开始冥想，然后从她的躯体里产生了火，把自己燃烧成了灰烬。
And then she took birth again, and next life she became, well,Again, she got Lord Shiva for her husband in her next life.
于是她，她离开躯体了之后，然后再次投身，在下一世又成为了主希瓦的妻子。
But not through Daksha.
但是并不是从 Daksha 那里来的。
So, Daksha.Sometimes he had, because he has a big position in the material world, sometimes he becomes proud.
Daksha, 因为在物质世界有一个这么样的一个位置，有些时候他变得骄傲。
So we say pride comes before the fall.
在堕落之前都会骄傲。
So Daksha became proud and then he fell down.
Daksha 一堕落他就骄傲，哦不，一骄傲他就堕落。
He offended Lord Shiva, that's an offense against a devotee, it's very serious.
他冒犯了主希瓦，主希瓦是一位伟大的奉献者，这是一个很严重的冒犯。
So, Ajamila, in the story of Ajamila, Ajamila was sinful, but he was not offensive.
我们看阿加米勒的故事，他虽然是一个罪恶者，但是他并不是一个冒犯者。
But Daksha was offensive.
但是 Daksha 却是一个冒犯者。
So he gave up that body, he took birth again, and became humble.
因此 Daksha 放弃了他的一个躯体，然后再一次投身的时候，他变得谦卑了。
Well, actually, what happened was, after Sati killed herself, after Sati gave up her body, then Lord Shiva's men, Lord Shiva's associates all came there, and they fought with Daksha and all of Daksha's men, and they cut off Daksha's head, and they gave him the head of a goat.
这个里面还有一些事情，就是当 Sati 放弃他的躯体的时候， Shiva 的所有的这些同游追随者们就来了，来到现场之后，他们把 Daksha 的头给砍掉，然后换了一个羊头给 Daksha。
So Daksha, it was so, he felt so ashamed in the head of a goat, so he gave up his life and took birth again.
Daksha 换了一个羊头之后，他觉得非常的惭愧，于是他放弃了这个躯。放弃了这个躯体，然后再一次投生。
Okay.
Next question from Jai Govinda, David Dasi. 顶拜孤儒和翻译，请问现实生活中有没有一位总是喜欢心智推敲的哲学家 最终通过奉爱服务又走向完美的例子呢？ A basis to guru and translator. I want to ask, in our material life, are there any example of that, one who always like mental speculation, he's a philosopher, but finally he become perfection by doing the devotional service?
Yes.
有这样的例子。
Like the four kumaras.
四苦马尔就是这样的例子。
It says Sukadeva Goswami, he was also fixed on the platform of impersonal Brahman, and then he heard Srimad Bhagavatam, became a devotee.
而且 Sukadeva Goswami 他也是把他的专注力总是放在非人格的 Brahman 的身上，由于聆听了圣典薄伽瓦堂而成为了奉献者。
Many examples. Lord Chaitanya, Lord Chaitanya brought Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya. Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya was a big guru in Jagannath Puri, and Lord Chaitanya made it. He was a big impersonalist. He was a big speculator, Gyani, and Lord Chaitanya made him a devotee.
包括 Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, 他是 Jagannath Puri 一个很伟大的这个哲学家，他总是喜欢哲学思辨，而且他是一个非人格主义者，但是主柴塔尼亚把他变成了一位奉献者。
In the pastimes of Lord Chaitanya there are several examples, people who were brought to Krishna consciousness by Lord Chaitanya from being impersonalists.
在主柴塔尼亚的逍遥时光，有那么几位人，他们都是非人格主义者，但是由于主柴塔仁慈，他们变成了奉献者。通过主柴塔尼亚，他们成为了奉献者。
Lord Chaitanya made all the Mayavadi sannyasis in Benares. He converted them to devotees.
主柴塔尼亚把贝纳勒斯的 Mayavadi。主义的这些三尼亚西全部都变成了奉献者。Okay, next question from Yuna. Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj and dear devotees, please accept my humble obeisances. All glory to Srila Prabhupada. Question: Prajapati Daksha was very pious person, very learned.How could it happen that he offended Lord Shiva? Thank you. Same question.
Yeah, similar question. Yeah, my is.
这个 Yuna Mataji 的，我先翻译。Yuna Mataji 的问题是 ，Prajapati Daksha 是一位非常虔诚的人，非常博学，他是如何冒犯了主西瓦呢？谢谢。
Yeah, that was the previous life, right? So.
嗯。
Maya is very powerful. Anybody can fall victim to Maya.
Maya is 非常有力量的，每一个人都可能被 Maya 征服。
You have to be very careful.
我们得非常的小心。
Never underestimate Krishna's energy.
我们无法理解 Krishna 的能量。
Even Bharat Maharaj was a very advanced devotee, but he fell victim to Maya.
Bharat Maharaj 也是一位非常伟大的奉献者，但是他也被 Maya 征服。
He became a deer. He had to spend another life in the material world.
他成为了一条小鹿，然后再花了一生在这个物质世界。
So we see in Srimad Bhagavatam, we see examples, some devotees that they don't get so successful, they're not so perfect, they have failures, they have fall downs.
我们在圣典伯加瓦坛里面看到有一些人，他们不是那么的完美，或不是那么的成功，他们失败过。
Yeah. Any other question?
No. Finish. 结果没有问题了。
Okay. So we will stop here.
Okay. Thank you.
So, well, thank you all the devotees for all your questions. And thanks to Buddy Ray for translating. And thanks Sati for being the administrator. Okay, Srila Prabhupada Ki.
Jai.
Okay, Guru Maharaj. Thank you, Subhri Roy Prabhu. Thank you so much for listening. Hare Krishna.
Srila Prabhupada Ki. Jai. Go back to Vrinda Ki.